Hi there, my name's Andy Collins. Welcome along to this lesson where I'm going to be teaching you how to play Decode by Paramore. Now, of course, this one is from the film Twilight, so it's a great song if you maybe a pasty white boy and you feel like wooing a gothic girl or something like that. Cool song as well, though, and not a bad movie as well. So what I'm going to do is just play through to start with so you can see how it sounds, and then we'll break things up a little bit. So there it is played through. Now the first thing you'll notice is the guitar tone on this. It's a weird sort of sound. Now I've messed around. I'm using a pod pedal here, and I've done the best I can to try and mimic that sound. What I've actually taken was a Jimi Hendrix preset and altered a little bit from there. So if you notice little bits of sort of Jimi Hendrix-y tone in it, all this. That's old Jimi Hendrix stuff. It's actually a similar sort of tone. It's this weird little synth thing that I found. I'm going to do a separate video on that. So let's keep straight to what's actually happening here in the song. Now, something that you will want to get for this is I've even put together that backing track that you heard at the start there. I've used Give Me Drums for that, and then I've thrown it together. There actually is on Nail Guitar, I've put together that backing track for you, so you can actually download it for yourself and play along once you've gone through this a few times and got the solo together. And of course, as with all songs, there's the transcription there as well. All you have to do, go onto the page and just sign up to the VIP section. Just put in your name and your email. Doesn't cost you anything, and you can download transcriptions to all the other songs I've got, as well as, with the backing track as well. So do that now, go grab it, come back, and then you'll have the transcription to follow this through. Cool, we've done that. Here we are again. So let's have a look at what's going on in this solo. There's not a whole lot of tricky stuff there, but what I want to do is focus on some of the techniques that might catch you out. So something that's very much repeated in this is this whole bend motif that we've got here. Now what is going on there is we're getting our 13th fret, we're bending up a fret, and then we're coming back down. And then we're playing 11. Now what will happen is, if that's new to you and you haven't done a lot of bends before, you might get some weird things like, or, you know, horrible cat screechy sounds. What you want to be aware of is where you're bending to and how long each of these notes lasts for. The notes that are actually going on are really more like this. If I play it without a bend, that's actually what we're aiming for. We're aiming for 13th fret, then we're bending to the 14th fret. That's how you want your bend to sound. You want it to sound like 13, 14, 13, 11. So practice it by doing picking first of all. 13, 14, 13, 11. Once you've done that a few times, it tends to even out that bend and stops it sounding like, you know, wacky and all over the place. So that's the first little challenge in there. Jumping up to the 13th on the E. That's two times. Third time, we're going to get a slide from that 11 down to the 9. 9, 9. Then we're going to reach over with our second, and we're going to get 10th fret on the D, 11 with our third finger, and then first finger on the 9. 8. So, sort of halfway through. Let's see how that sounds all together. And here it is. So that's our halfway point there. Second half starts off again with this bending idea. Reason why I was hammering down on that so much to, you know, say get that, is because it's all the way through the thing. So if it sounds bad, it doesn't sound bad once, it sounds bad, you know, 8 times. So that's why it's so important. So we've got that repeated over again. Now we're on the 13. So we're going to get 13, 13, then 13 sliding up to the 14. Now we're going to make a jump here. We're going to jump up to the 16, and we're going to play 18 after that. So what we're going to do is jump over, do a bit of leapfrog with our fingers, and we're going to jump up with our first finger there. So 16, 18 with our first and our third finger. That's important. Then we're jumping back with our first finger on the 14. And we're going to slide that down to 13. Now, if you had that ringing out, it should ring out for you. You need a fair bit of distortion. This patch that I'm using on my pedal there is pretty high gain. If you don't have that, you'll find that you'll have happen what happened to me the first time there. If you leave it too long or if you've got low distortion, you won't really get anything there. Bit of vibrato keeps it continuing on as well. So that kind of takes us into the breakdown of the song. So those are the key things in there. Make sure that you're using the right fingers. This little phrase down here before. And using your first and your third finger. Often see people using their second finger for bends. Not a good habit. You want to use all three of these fingers to support that and give you that control in the bend so you're bending to pitch. So that's probably the main challenge in this one. It's a really good workout for your bends. So if you want to work on some more things on your bends, on the sister YouTube page for this one, Nail Guitar Skills, I'm going to be doing some bending lessons on there. So, you know, it'll either soon be on that page or it will already be on there. Depends on when you're looking at this video. So there you go. That's our solo all the way through. You can jump back to the start and you can have another listen through and watch through the video of the full example. And you can also get yourself the backing track for that I've put together so you can play through and, you know, be a glory guitar hero yourself playing the big solo section. So there we go. So grab the bits from Nail Guitar and I'll catch you again for another lesson soon.